Hello, I'm Dr. Chip Cooney at the Animal Hospital of Statesville, and today we're going to have a little discussion on fleas and ticks. Now, these are both very common external parasites of pets we see here in North Carolina. Fleas, though, we're going to spend a whole lot more time on because ticks are a little more seasonal, more of a spring and summer issue. Fleas, pretty much a year-round problem here in North Carolina. And the other thing is that the vast majority of my flea products also treat for ticks, so we kind of two birds with one stone type situation. So the big thing here is why are we dealing with fleas this time of year? You know, here we are in the fall, things are getting cooler, the colors are changing, this is a strange time to talk about fleas. Well, that may seem to be the case. But honestly, the fall is always our worst time for fleas. We'll see fleas worse in October, namely, than any other month. We'll see fleas just crawling all over pets. And the question is why? And the answer is, well, we're really not sure. Are owners getting more complacent with their flea control during this time of year? Well, that may be the case. Things are getting cooler. You don't worry about it as much. But more likely, it is due to the life cycle of the flea. And we're going to touch on that here in a little bit on why that builds and builds through the summer. And in the fall, we have a big issue. So how do we find fleas on your pet? The answer is, we look. You can take the hairs over the tail head, pull it up, and many times you can see the flea scurrying underneath there. If we roll the pet on their back and look in the groin area where there's not much hair, many times you can see the fleas there also. Fleas are just a few millimeters long, and they run pretty quickly, but you really can't miss them. We also look for them down along the hamstrings, down the back legs where the feathers are. Many times we will see the fleas in that area as well. We also use this. This little nifty item is called a flea comb and really helps us in finding fleas on your pet. Flea combs have very small, narrow little teeth, and using these, we are able to come across the pet. Many times we'll pick up fleas. A lot of times we pick up what is called flea dirt. Flea dirt's a nice name for flea poop. Flea poop is dried blood. So fleas bite and suck the blood from your pet and poop out the blood. If you find this black stuff, you can even put it on a nice white paper towel, put a drop of water on there, and you'll see it turn red, which is the blood. So those are some of the ways we find fleas on your pet. So the big thing here is, as we work through this, is why do fleas become a problem in the fall? Well, that's where the flea life cycle comes in. So I'm going to introduce you now to the flea pyramid. And this is our flea pyramid. So this is a flea pyramid. And everybody in our clinic is well versed on the flea pyramid. So what this is showing is a life cycle of the flea. The flea lays eggs, which then hatch out into larvae, which are like little worms, and then they molt into pupae, which are cocoons, much like a butterfly, and then eventually they hatch back out into fleas. So when we look at this problem, 95% of our problem is environmental, with only 5% of the problem being the adult flea in the environment. And when we look at this flea laying 50 eggs a day, let's put 10 fleas on this pet, there's 500 eggs a day, and let's do that for 2 days, or 3 days, or 4 days, and you see why this environmental issue can build up so quickly. This life cycle can be as quick as a few days, and it can last for months depending on the conditions for the pet. So this is why we truly see the problems in the fall, because these flea life cycles have been building up for the full year. Pets that are allergic to the flea saliva develop severe inflammation and scratch and itch and develop what are called hot spots, which leads to secondary infection, which is painful. So once again, very important to keep the fleas off your pets. I frequently get asked in North Carolina, are fleas a year-round problem? Well, here they are. There have been some studies done, and we need 5 consecutive days where the temperature does not go above 30 degrees to kill all the flea life cycles. And that just doesn't happen here in North Carolina. So yes, flea protection needs to occur year-round here. You might say, my pet never goes outside. Why should I even worry about flea prevention? Of course, inside pets are at a much lower risk than outside pets are. However, many times we have pets who do go outside and come back inside, and they can carry fleas to your pet. Occasionally we'll deal with possums or raccoons that set up shop under a deck or in a crawl space. those fleas can easily make their way to the pets. And even you can bring fleas into the home, though honestly that's pretty rare. But here's the thing, if you think of it, it only takes one flea to start this life cycle. One flea at 50 eggs a day, we start doing the math. You can see it's safer and easier for you to have pet on flea prevention than to have to deal with an infestation you may not be aware of for days or weeks or even months. So yes, inside-only pets still should be on flea prevention. So then people say, well, when do I need to treat the fleas? Well, the answer is now. With fleas producing 50 eggs a day, we want to get those flea eggs under control as soon as possible, and we do that by killing the fleas as soon as possible. So now is the best time to start. People want to treat the house. Do I need to call an exterminator? Well, that's not a bad idea, but I tell people you can do a pretty good job just by vacuuming well. These flea eggs are down in the carpets, they're down in the couch, they're down in the bed, they're down in the crawl spaces of wherever the pet hangs out. Well, places you can get to, vacuum really, really well. Let's try to suck up as many of those eggs and pupae as possible, and then let's throw the vacuum bag away. You do not want to put that in your closet and then go get the vacuum in a few weeks, because those flea eggs will then be ready to hatch out and attack you, and we don't want that. Also get asked, do I need to have the yard treated? Well, again, you can. It's not a wrong thing to do, but I tell people, let's treat the pet. The fleas hang out in warm, moist environments, not in the middle of the backyard. If your pet hangs out under the deck or in the bushes in a mulch pile, well, yeah, those areas are probably not a bad idea to treat. But as far as treating the whole yard, not a huge issue. Let's take care of the pet. So now that we've talked about fleas, let's talk about how to prevent the infestation and keep that flea pyramid from ever getting out of control. So there are multiple ways to treat fleas in pets, and I'm going to kind of divide them into different categories. The first is going to be topical products. So there are many topical products on the market, over-the-counter products such as pyrethrins and pyrethroids. Or what we originally started with many, many years ago. And they can work, but they're not terribly effective. And I'll be honest, we do not recommend them anymore. And especially with the pyrethroids on cats, can be highly toxic to cats. So we always want to be careful with those products. The next family of over-the-counter products are things such as Frontline, things such as Advantage, Advantix. These are much more effective topical products. And actually, I like them, and we still carry Advantix in the clinic here. Key note here, do not use Advantix on your cat. All right, but back to this. We like these products. They work pretty well. The downfall is they do produce kind of a gooey wet spot on the pet, as you have to produce them in many places down the back. They also don't work great for the full months period of time, and that's been our issue with them. We feel like for 2 weeks they work fabulous, they really do a nice job, and by the third week they're petering out a little bit, not doing quite as good a job, and by that fourth week, well, they're just not doing much, and that's the time when that reinfestation can occur, the life cycle can continue, and we're right back to where we were. So while we like the topicals, we're not a huge fan of them. There are several products that are safe for cats. They are topical products, and we do like them a lot. Brevecto for cats is a topical. Revolution Plus for cats is a topical. Advantage Multi for cats is a topical. These are all very safe for cats and very effective for cats. So the next category are flea and tick collars. So everybody's heard of flea and tick collars, and with one exception, I tell people that you might as well throw your money out the window on your way to buy it, because you're getting the same effectiveness from it. Flea and tick collars just don't work, except for the Seresto collar. Seresto collar is proven to be a good product. We have clients who use them and are very, very happy with it. I have others that we do find fleas and ticks on the pet, but the Seresto collar needs to be applied tightly, and the product leaves the collar and works, and it can work really well. But you also have to take it off anytime you bathe the pet, and you also have to be careful with the pet swimming, because that will inactivate that collar. Our favorite products are the new oral products. The ioxazoline classification of flea product has been just absolutely wonderful, and it kills ticks also. These products such as Brevecto and Credelio and Simparica and NexGard have just been great. People have had no problems giving them to their pets. The Simparica product is labeled for puppies 8 weeks and up, so it's very, very safe. They kill fleas in 30 minutes and they work for 30 days, except for Brevecta, which works for 90 days. And the nice new product, Simparica Trio, is not only doing the same thing for fleas and ticks, but is also preventing a heartworm and intestinal worm. So if it comes to truly the best product for your fleas and tick problems, we're a big fan of the oral products. The last classification that I'm going to talk about are the all-natural products. Things like the diatomaceous earth, garlic, essential oils. Those products are just really, really hard for us to tell you anything about because there aren't any good scientific studies talking about them. The anecdotal studies that people come up with that you read a website on say these great things, but I'll be honest, we just don't see it in here. We see pets with fleas who are using these products and we just don't find them very effective. We just tell you if you want to try them, that's fine, but be very careful. Make sure you trust your source. So you have heard more information about fleas than you probably ever hoped to hear. Hopefully I answered most, if not all, of your questions today. But if you have any others, don't hesitate to give us a call up here. We'll be happy to work with you, and I'm confident we can get rid of your flea problems. Thank you. Tick products are also flea products, and let's start over because I didn't mean to talk like that. So fleas.
It's okay.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. That's how you mess around. I was like, all right. Well.
I can only hear you out of one ear.
So I was like, so drunk. Mono. Why flea? No, I'm not ready.
Just keep going.
Okay. The flea can take the flea, blah, blah, blah. Dang, gummit. But these pets who are allergic to the saliva can gummit. Kyle. The pets who are allergic to the flea saliva develop severe inflammation in the area. Gosh, I got the saliva, didn't I?
Saliva.
All right.
I never heard you say that before.
Yeah.
Just keep going.
So once again, we do recommend that all fleas, indoor or out, just frontline for cats. What's the other one? I can't remember the product's name, and it's called Revolution Plus. That's our number one product, unfortunately.